There's a gentleman on YouTube who makes plastic puzzles and plastic gear sets. I saw one of his eccentric planetary drives and decided to make one out of wood. I'll put a link to his channel in the description. I ran this disc through the drum sander multiple times and reduced what was originally 1/4 inch thick plywood to what is now 3/16. One of these doublers is pinned to the back side of the front ring gear plate. I've taken another one of these pieces of scrap and reduced the thickness of that. Now I take my sander, and I'm using this as a sanding guide that keeps my disc from getting up here on this 1/4 inch bearing surface. And I just want to taper those teeth to provide a little bit of clearance for this disc. And you can see how your sanding is progressing because you'll start sanding away this outside veneer. When I put the disc in there, I've got clearance here because I made this disc a little bit thinner. Those teeth are no longer rubbing on this. So now that should turn more freely. In order to drive one of the planet gears, the motor would require a more complicated mount, allowing it to follow a circular path. Since this is a static demonstration model, I have chosen to drive the carrier disc, allowing the motor to remain stationary. Wood dowels were cut to length and glued into each of these gears. You stick that on there, and using one of these end cap washers I made, use that center point to drill a hole into that dowel. I burned some washers made out of formica. screw that holds that end cap or retaining washer in position. And that washer keeps these teeth from rubbing on this plate. Each of these receive a spacer washer. The front ring gear plate is pinned to the doubler plate. Now I'm doing that with sharp pieces of 1/8-inch wood dowel. When you're sure everything is fitting as you want it and you've tapered the teeth, you can glue these two pieces together on a flat surface. You know, plywood, again, sometimes not flat. Clamp that to a flat surface while it dries, and that will be an assembly. This goes in here. And the next part will be a retainer. The job of the retainer is to trap that disc, keep it from coming out of there. Another piece, which is identical to the retainer, goes on here. And that just creates additional clearance so nothing will hit these end caps while they're turning. Then the final piece is the back plate. The back plate provides a rear bearing for this shaft, and this is where the motor will mount. When you're sure this is going together as you want it, glue this together on a flat surface as an assembly. We will then have the front assembly, the rear assembly, and the carrier assembly. I always like to put these things together to where they can be taken apart. As soon as you glue something together solid, Murphy's Law dictates that something will go wrong. I turned the motor adapter shaft on the lathe, and this is drilled out 6 millimeter to fit on this motor shaft. A 6/32 set screw to tighten on that flat. In the video, I showed drilling these two holes, and I had hoped that I had chosen correctly to get these pins to be a press fit in there, but drill bits don't always drill that accurate, and it was a little bit too loose. So I re-drilled those, and I didn't go all the way through. Shortened the pins a little bit, put them in there with Loctite, and they're there to stay. On this one, we're driving the center of this carrier plate, or the carrier disc, and it's turning all the gears. Not everything you experiment with is going to turn out the way you think. I cut the dowel off on one of these and put one of my adapters on there, and it matches up to this motor drive adapter that I machined. And using a 3 RPM motor, I was able to turn this, and it turned it pretty well. But for various reasons, I didn't like that. And so I've decided to go ahead and drive this off of this sun gear. And this is so much easier to drive, and it's easier on the motor. So that's the direction I'm headed now. Well, fortunately, I did not glue these different pieces together yet. And what was on this side has been changed out to a 3-inch opening. When this goes together, my motor drive will fit in here, and I need to make a mount for the motor so it can follow this around. And that's fairly easy to do. I have a piece that will go on here. Then there's a piece that will slide back and forth. The motor mounts to that. So now the motor can slide back and forth and swing left and right. There's another piece that pins on here. Since this is hanging on the wall, this keeps this from trying to lift. One of the legs. And these are feet or legs that are standoff from the wall. There's three more of those. And the reason for the pin drive is when that's on the bottom side of the motor, when you go to put this back assembly on there, it's a lot easier to make that connection.